Welcome back, Reef Builders. I'm Jake Adams, and I am continuing this mini-series here showing you some of the new reef aquarium displays at the Reef Builder Studio. If you're just stumbling across this video, make sure to go back a few days and check out my previous video on the new Innovative Marine Nouveau 40 gallon that has a lot of bony LPS corals. But for this tank right behind me, we have a different setup with some more familiar corals. So let's take a look at those. So this is the Innovative Marine Nouveau 75 gallon EXT aquarium. It's 3 feet long, kind of a squarish back pane, and high clarity glass. You'll see that this tank is actually aquascaped all with purple life rock from Carib Sea. Now, I'm not usually a big fan of the ready-made rock because all the shapes kind of turn out the same. But one thing that's really cool about the life rock is it has like lots of bumps, lots of sections and kind of projections that makes it really cool and easy to kind of lock the pieces together in fun and interesting ways. So there's probably about 40 to 50 pounds of the Carib Sea life rock inside. This tank is illuminated by two Cetus II LEDs. These are by HM Electronics out of Taiwan. And they're actually a really fun Bluetooth controlled mini cluster of LEDs. So there's multiple colors in each of them. They've got a primary lens. And it doesn't really focus the light nearly as much as some other lights that we're used to. So when the lights are off, when the lights are off on this tank and the tank next to it, you can actually kind of see just how much light it bleeds off into the side tanks. I could drop these down a little bit lower to concentrate some of that light, but I'm really enjoying them as is now, and I'll probably use them on some nano aquariums in the future. So like I said, this is tied into a major system, a centralized aquarium system. So there is kind of a common filtration system. But for water flow, I'm doing something a little bit different here. So we've got the Vortec MP10 here on both sides. We've got one over there, and we've got one over there. And I'm trying something a little bit new with the aquascape and the placement of the Vortex that I haven't done before, but I've been thinking about for a while. So normally I would almost always just have my power heads or my water flow producers up at the top, kind of moving that top layer. But what I wanted to do is start the strong flow out in the back and just have that channel start in the back and just kind of sweep over and then just kind of wash over the reef from both directions. And at times the power heads will meet in the middle and kind of come through this chamber. And you can see my holy grail torch has got perfect placement to really, really blow around. And so yeah, not much to it. We've got two MP10s, we've got two LED lights, and some Carib Sea Life Rock. So as you can already tell, this tank is dedicated. It's kind of the opposite, of the LPS tank over here where nothing's moving. In this tank, almost everything is moving. So far we've got, it's pretty much as a Euphilia biotope, I guess you could say. So I got my hammer corals, torch corals, frog spawn, cristata, and all kinds of funky different corals. There's a funky coral from my buddy Vincent, a probable hybrid, and then some Galaxy in the back. I've been growing on a magnetic frag rack for a long time. Yes, I know the first one is kind of receding, but that thing's grown from a frag, so we'll hack it out and make a lot of pieces. So yeah, just kind of one bommy there, a little bit smaller bommy there. And so one of the challenges that I'm having with having all the power heads in the back is it kind of uses up a good 5-6 inch section in the back where the water needs to flow through. So I can't get the rock back nearly as far as I would like, but I am going to fix this by using corals on magnetic frag basis. So we've started over there with the bubble coral, we've got the Galaxy over here. So you can expect to see a whole lot more magnetically mounted shelves and corals in the back. So that way I can kind of encase the water flow that's going through. You may have noticed my school of native white mollies, my saltwater mollies. These are just regular mollies that have been adapted to seawater. water. And I think we're up to like 60 or 75 of them here. And something a little bit more familiar is gonna be the Spot Synctis clownfish. And I put in a beautiful, beautiful red, they're called delicate anemones, so they're related to long tentacles, but they stay really flat. And I put it in a basket with a little bit of rubble, because these guys like to have their foot in some rubble or some sand that they can retreat into. And so far, that's actually proven to be a pretty good hack for keeping the anemone in place. So it's been maybe like 10 days or so, and the anemone has not budged at all. And it only took the Spot Synctis clownfish maybe a week to kind of find it. They're still not like totally married to it like they would with some other anemone types. But yeah, so here's the Euphyllia garden, if you will. This side is pretty full and looking really, really good. There is a yellow tang in here somewhere. Oh, he's hiding back there. And yeah, we're gonna get more fish in here, definitely more euphyllias. I'm gonna show these tanks off a little bit more in depth as they grow and develop. But this tank is only 2 weeks old so far. So yeah, I hope you like this preview of the second new system here at the Reef Builder Studio. It's looking really, really good. And next up on my next video, it's gonna be the Innovative Marine 100 gallon EXT, which is filled with soft corals and turbinaria. So, if you don't wanna miss that, make sure to comment, like, subscribe, and I will catch you guys on the next video.